Code Corp principal and Wiper leader Kalonzo Musyoka has dismissed talk that he was likely to quit NASA for Jubilee. The former vice president says that rumor is malicious. His deputy Farah Malim joins me to talk more about this in just a bit. But front page of the Daily Nation as well, this title there is Kalonzo faces revolt over Raila betrayal. Wiper party chief faces internal rebellion over suspicions that he might turn his back on his opposition colleagues and stage his own stab at the presidency. His allies claim leader as a list of preferred candidates for various posts in Ukambani as well. And Honorable Farah Malim joins me, is the Wiper deputy party leader. Is there some internal rebellion in Wiper?
Look, I can speak authoritatively on behalf of the party on this particular issue. There is no rebellion in the party. On the contrary, the party is growing almost like a wildfire now.
Yeah.
In the four corners of the country. And they are the traditional handlers, you know, what you call tribal handlers, who more or less kept the party like an ethnic cocoon initially, or a small ethnic entity, who feel they're losing grip of the party itself. And there's no favored candidate in here.
Now, as recently as Sunday, we had the former vice president, that's Kalonzo Musyoka, saying that Raila Odinga has had several stabs at the presidency, now you should pave the way. You don't read like he wants to see, do this on
you
his
see,
own.
That is a healthy internal engagement, which is, as far as we are concerned, it does not in any way, undermine the NASA coalition. Wiper and Kalonzo Musyoka, you could say the strongest pillar in NASA itself. There is no way he's going to leave NASA or the Wiper party is going to go on its own alone.
But we saw this in 2007.
Yes, you saw it in 2007 because there was a massive betrayal. You know, sometimes it's important to understand the merits and the demerits of a matter itself, the case in point. At that time, there was very underhand, manner that in itself, his other friends saw as to eliminate his possibility of being the flag bearer for that coalition at that time, to undermine him, and it was a public spite. He went for a rally to Khadija grounds in Mombasa, and here were these youths who were prepared and who all came with a hammer. So this was a staged matter, and clearly, people are supposed to be gentlemen when they're dealing with one another. So that primitive way in which it was handled, which cost the opposition, or rather that time, that alliance with the coalition, the landslide victory that it ought to have had, was not caused by him. On the contrary, he was a clean, suave, you know, decent, very, in a sense, in Kenya, it looks like sometimes you say, when somebody is tricky, when somebody, you know, dribbles the balls and plays and backstabs and the rest of it, there's a tendency to see him as a hero in politics. No. It's always good to transact the game of politics itself and the merchandise of politics in a very systematic and a very decent manner.
But it is that
above
scene.
So at that time, that was the cause of it. You know what I mean, and of course it's important. Sometimes you have a certain ego, you have a prestige, you have an image, and a time will come when you will say, well, for whatever it takes, I cannot be subjected to this kind of humiliations, because nobody is any lesser human or lesser, what do you call somebody, than the other. Yeah. But right now, as things stand out, I think we've all wisened up, and whatever that was played at that time by ODM those days, never got there also, because nobody can go on his own. So right now we have a very powerful camaraderie between the principals, as well as the deputy principals who are with them now. So we keeping this together, and we'll have a compromise candidate.
Yeah.
And for somebody to jostle to become the compromise candidate within that, in a way, is also you're building the base also of the party, because Kalonzo is now going to non-traditional Wiper areas and zones to basically go and sell a Wiper party, because we still don't have a single party where we all come in. NASA is not a party.
But do you see where the suspicion is coming from? In fact, that is part of the reasons it earned him the name Watermelon and Chameleon, that he could easily change, and him calling, saying it out loud and kissing, that he should be given the chance to do it.
Well, you see, when you have an internal discourse within a coalition, it's more or less like a primary. Everybody has got to go and present himself and say, look, I should be the preferred candidate among us, among the rest of us. It's a normal way of selling that coalition. And at the same time, fronting yourself and saying, hey, maybe this time I should get your support.
But the concern is, what if you don't get your support?
No. If he doesn't get, he's going to remain inside still. There's a committee which has been set up. You know the committee. This committee is the one that's going to go through that. And who knows who's going to be the flag bearer for NASA coalition. You see, the presumption, like whoever is now gave out this, it says, Kalonzo faces revolt over Raila betrayal. You know, it's Raila, it's not Raila, he's going to be betrayed. It's a coalition that's going to be betrayed. So there's already a presumption that there is an entity which has been built around Raila in the eyes and the minds of these people who have given this statement.
That's because he mentioned Raila out there.
No.
He said Raila.
No. He's not going
to. We have that soundbite. We could play it out.
But you see, the point is, it's like he said, I supported Raila last time.
Yes.
I expect other people to support me this time too. In the unlikely event, or whatever likely event, that somebody else is going to become the compromise candidate, I will abide by the rules and I will operate by the rules. You see what I mean? And who are the people talking about this right now? It is not Raila's camp. It's not Wetangula's camp. It's not Mudavadi's camp. It's people who have their own issues back in Ukambani. And I'll explain to you, wait. You see, the people who are talking about it are the Ukambani leaders. So who is betraying who, for example? In the first place, if they're in Wiper, ordinarily they should be happy if their own leader becomes a compromise candidate. You know what I mean? They shouldn't be mooting for somebody else when they are in another party. And nothing has become cast so much in stone to suggest that Raila, Wiper leader, has bolted. Then you can come out and say that we are not going to bolt with him. You know what I mean? But the man has not bolted, has no intention of bolting. These are people who are seeking direct nomination to run as governors. For example, in the case of the chairman of the party, he wants to run for the governorship of Kitui. And he wants to be given a direct nomination because he claims he was one of the founders of the party itself. But how do you then deny a fair, what do you call, nomination process to a sitting governor?
Now that you brought Malombe that up, are there any governor preferred candidates? Because that is
No. He has no preferred candidate. He has been very categorical, by the way. Mm-hmm. Very categorical, and say there will be free and fair nomination processes. Anytime you decide to influence those nominations, what happens to you is exactly what happened to ODM before. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And you can see Raila today. Raila allays fears over direct tickets. He knows the price we paid in ODM last time by trying to give direct tickets to certain individuals who are seeking offices.
So you do admit that
there will be no direct tickets. There will be absolutely no direct tickets.
So last time you tried to give direct tickets.
In ODM?
Yes.
Oh, that cost us a lot, yes. We should have done much better than that. Right. We lost the elections, including the presidency, because of some of those things. I mean, it's a pity. We've learned our lesson, both as a coalition, and you can see Raila Odinga is talking about it right now. Okay. You see, what happens is that, you see, this is no longer a tribal party. It's a national party. So the moment something grows, the handlers that were used to a small thing that they have a control over will begin feeling insecure. And that's precisely what it is right now.
Yeah.
You understand my point?
But
so what we are telling our friends, what we are telling our members is, look, go and fight it out in the nomination. It's going to be a very fair and a very straight nomination. Whoever emerges, let the best man or woman take it.
Okay.
Nobody's going to get a direct nomination.
But also those same Ukambani leaders you're talking about are saying that Kalonzo is being warned on going it alone. So they say that if he gets out of the coalition,
but I have just told you that.
Let me finish my question. They're saying that they're only with him if he's in the coalition. What does that say about the actual unity?
Look,
because they're with him on condition that he remains.
Look. Did you ever ask yourself, has anybody else in ODM said we're only going to be with Raila as long as he stays in the coalition? Have you ever seen anybody in ANC saying that we're only going to be with him as long as he leaves the coalition? That leaving of the coalition is not an issue. It's not on the table. So why do you speculate on something that's not there? It's because, I'll tell you why, it's because they feel, some of them, they have no chance in that free and fair nomination process. You understand my point? If you don't have a chance, last time what happened is that using precisely this direct tickets.
Tickets, yeah.
How many Ukambani members of parliament who wanted to be in Wiper were denied the tickets, ended up with other parties and came to parliament? Very many. I don't know if you know that. Good number of them. Out in Machakos County alone, out of, I think, 8 members of parliament, 5 of them are not in the party. The 5 of them all wanted to be in the party. But you see, these handlers, succeeded in literally, you know, basically giving the direct nominations to their own friends and preferred candidates. So we've learned, the party has learned its own lessons on this. They're never going to do that. Mm-hmm. The issue is when you lose in the nomination, I'm talking to them right now, don't bolt from the party and don't bolt from the coalition. Because our fear is the same guys who are talking that way are likely to bolt into Jubilee. You know what I mean? You understand my point? So they're trying to create a case for themselves. Oh, I was rigged out in the nomination or this kind of things. Nobody's going to be rigged out. It's going to be an open, transparent, clear, and let the best person take it.
Yeah.
And that's our position right now. As for the party, it's a national party. It's not a, what do you call a community party. Mm. It's no longer an Ukambani party. It's a Kenyan party.
Yeah.
That's the point.
And Mutula Kilonzo has been quoted as saying that there are certain individuals who are misadvising the party leader. That's Kalonzo Musyoka.
Let him tell us. He's always with us. Yeah. He's always with us. His advice, he's been there in the roadshow that we went through, sensitizing, what do you call, the people of Makueni, Machakos, and Kitui counties to go and register themselves in record numbers. You get my point. Mm-hmm. And in any case, if these are all leaders in the party, why not raise these issues in a party neck meeting? The chairman can call for a party neck meeting any day, mm-hmm. and say that we have these problems, there are these fears, what are the issues? You understand my point? The mere fact that they are working outside the institution in a manner that, you know, for a lack of a better word, is a chaos and anarchy. You know what I mean? It doesn't work. I mean, this is not the way you run a civilized organization in this day and age. Mm. You do it in the manner it has to be done, unless you have your problems. Are you getting my point?
Yeah.
And the problems are likely to occur. They will occur in all the four corners of this country and in every party, because there are all those people who feel certain entitlement in getting the nomination of the party and in hanging on to the coattails of the party leader himself to be able to cross the bridge for their own personal benefit. That will not occur now in Wiper.
Yeah.
Everybody will carry his own cross in as far as seeking votes from the people of their counties at and all levels of what do you call election, whether it's a governor, a senator, a member of parliament, an MCA. And that's it. There will be no favoritism in that.
Okay. So as we come to an end, there's this allegation that the committee members will try and make sure that everyone is happy, quote unquote, by being given positions. That is, if they don't get the preferred condition.
Look.
Changing the whole scenario and making NASA seem like all they really want is selfish interest
rather than the interest of the Kenyan people. No. But to begin with, let me tell you one thing. That's speculations. Mm. Because I don't think you've talked to anybody from the committee. Mm. You don't have the inner details of
power. But you do.
I have the inner details. No. It's crap. Nonsense. I can tell you that.
There's no
sure.
such thing happening.
There's no such things. Like, the country is bigger than anything else. Mm. The clarion call is Kenya first. Kenya first. That's basically what it is. Mm. Party leader Kalonzo Musyoka said, if NASA were to determine and decide that he is going to run for an MCA seat in Sekuru, and say that for the sake of country and people of Kenya, we feel that we as a committee will sit down there and say that you go and run for an MCA seat. He said, I'm willing to do that for the sake of the country. You understand my point? At my age, he says, I only want to give to the country. And that's basically what it is.
All right.
So when somebody goes to the extent of giving you that kind of a statement, that fairness, that openness, that transparency, that what you call, we're breaking the barriers of, you know, exclusivity before, you know, the exclusion, a small group owns a party, a small group owns power. No, that's gone.
All right.
As far as we are concerned, in our own party and in the coalition, that will no longer be there.
So you believe this?
Yes, the coalition is going to hold. The coalition is going to have its own systems in there. Look, we cannot do anything outside the constitution. We're not going to create the office of the prime minister. We're not going to create the office of what? Anything else you want to talk about, you know, which is not in the constitution. But within the constitution, we will be able to manage our own party affairs or coalition affairs in a manner that essentially we feel is going to guarantee us a victory at the end of it. And that's just the beginning of the work. Okay. Work for Kenyans and change the rot.
Finally, what do you make of the concerns by the likes of Musila warning party leader Kalonzo Musyoka?
Look, Musila, he will get a fair play there.
Yeah.
If he's happy with a fair play, if he thinks the people of Kitui love him so much, they want to make him the governor of the place and they're sick and tired of the fellow who was there before, come and show us.
All right.
Show us what you're worth. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Show us the steel you're made for. We're going to have free and fair nominations in there. Right. The party leader will not be there. We'll have independent people doing it. And therefore, from then on, we say,
All right. Stay with me. Farah Maalim is staying with me, the Wiper Party leader and Wiper Party deputy leader. And there's Anne Okumu is checking your feedback right now. Anne, what are they saying?
Yes, Trevor, there's a hashtag that's trending here. It's been trending for a while. Salome divorces Farah Osta. In this case, Salome is Kalonzo Musyoka and Farao is Raila Odinga. So here Meshach says NASA iko imara, and then Charles here says when a wise man says danger ahead, he does not wait until he is pinched. Hashtag Salome divorces Farao. And then we have here Naivasha's finest says this is a one man dangerous party. Salome has to look for another way. Then we'll get some feedback from the honorable there. And then we have Tangania who says where there's smoke, there's fire. Kalonzo's heart is not in code NASA or NASWA. That's all we have for you, Trevor.
Thanks, Anne. What do you make of that? Salome,
well, you know, let me tell you one thing. I mean, I'm talking authoritatively on these things. And it doesn't, of course, everybody has his own persuasions. People support different parties, you know what I mean? But anybody who is going to wait for Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka to bolt out of NASA, will wait until hell freezes. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. He will wait forever, or she will wait forever.
So he's in this.
They will never come again.
All right.
So he's a front runner. You know what I mean? I mean he's there. He's one of the men who are going to change this country for the better in the future.
Okay.
With such a sterling history.
So
basically, and credibility and integrity and everything you can imagine. Those who are waiting for, I'm sure these are Jubilee supporters who are waiting for a Wiper or Kalonzo to bolt out. Too bad, you wouldn't have it this time. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Thanks, Farah. We leave it there for now. Farah Maalim, their Wiper deputy party leader.
Thank you.
Today, checking the front page of the Daily Nation, where Kalonzo faces revolt over Raila betrayal. The deputy party leader says there's no such thing happening and there are also no preferred candidates and Kalonzo will stay in NASA. However, there's a hashtag going on that Anne Okumu has just brought up to you guys where they say that Salome divorces Farao, claiming that where there's smoke, there is fire. We'll keep an eye on most of the things that you Kenyans are going to say.